Hello, second grade. I don't know about you, but I feel like I'm ready for spring. So I thought today we could do a spring picture. It's going to be of a rabbit, and it's going to have some pretty spring flowers in the background. So this will take us this lesson and the next one to finish. So today we're going to draw the rabbit. Now this is just the rabbit's face and like the top of its body. I'm going to be using two different size black markers. So these are both Sharpies. I have a thicker one and a thinner one. And if you have a black marker, great. If you don't, you can just use crayon, whatever you need to use to make it work. All right, so excuse me, I have a little bit of a cold. To start with, I'm actually going to draw it with pencil, and then I'm going to go over it with my Sharpie. So right in the middle of your paper, you want to draw what I call a rainbow line. And then that's going to come down a little ways. And then it's going to come out just a little bit. See how my lines are coming out a little bit? And then it's going to come down and around, down and around. And then we're going to put two lines, just two curved lines. This will be the body, top of the body. This is the head. And we're going to add some ears. Rabbits have nice long ears. So I'm going all the way to the top of my paper with the ears. Okay, now we're going to add the space for the eye. So we're going to come down and then go back over. So it comes to like a point. And then I'm going to just try to start in the same spot on the other side. This is why I need to use pencil because it's hard to do it exactly the same on the other side. So actually, I'm going to give myself a mark. So what I did was I go straight across here and made a little dot. Then I know about how far down I have to go. And that worked out much better. Now I still feel like this one's a little bit smaller. So I am going to make it a little bit bigger. Okay, doesn't have to be perfect. Okay, now. Right here below the eyes, and it doesn't have to be a perfect circle. We're going to draw a nice circle like that. And do you see this line here that was part of the head? That one we definitely want to erase. Now, inside this circle, I'm going to make another circle. And then inside that, I'm going to make a circle, but it's going to come up at the end, sort of like an upside down heart, but not pointy. Okay, so now that I have it basically drawn, I'm gonna use my Sharpie, and this is the fat Sharpie. To trace my lines. And if you have any pencil lines showing, you can just erase them then. Okay, so the reason that I said that this is going to take us two sessions is because this is going to take us a while, this part right here. So I'm going to put an eye, and I want to leave a little bit of it white, and I'm actually going to use my Sharpie and color in the eye, except for that little white spot. Okay, now we're going to then use this thin Sharpie, and I'm going to make lines that go across. First, the rabbit's ears. And then in the rabbits. So these are kind of curving up. And then I'm going to curve under for the eyes. And then across the body. Okay, so now I'm going to switch back to my thicker Sharpie, and we're going to just be drawing little black lines in each section. So it doesn't take a lot of time since we're just making little lines, but enough to keep us busy for one part of the lesson. Thank you. Okay. Now around the eye, we're going to make lines that come out, sort of like if you were drawing a sun. And you can add as many in there as you like. I just think it looks maybe a little bit better with a few more lines in there. All right, and then in this section, we're also going to be going around. And in this section, now this one, we're going to draw a line down and then kind of make, see how I'm making it thicker and darker, kind of like a mouth, and then a curved line here that will kind of look like the nose. So you want those thicker and so they stand out better. So I'm just adding to make the line get thicker. And then you just want to do a couple lines that way. Okay, and then we're just gonna finish the body the same way. And then when you think you're finished, you can go back over and look at your picture and see if there's any spaces that you feel like you need to add a couple more lines. So then when you think you're finished, you can go ahead and set that aside. Don't lose it, because we're going to finish it next time. All right, so I will see you for part two of the lesson very soon.